Have you ever pulled an all-nighter to meet a deadline or binge-watched your favorite TV series into the wee hours of the morning? Well, in today's fast-paced world, it's become almost a badge of honor to survive on minimal sleep. But here's the harsh truth. Skimping on sleep isn't a superpower. It's actually a silent assassin of your health, productivity, and overall well-being. And unfortunately, when students don't have enough time to finish their work, sleep is usually what they tend to cut time from. Well, today we will dive into the research and explain how sleep works, look at its benefits, and investigate why neglecting your sleep is very dangerous and why you should definitely rethink pulling an all-nighter. Sleep is something that we do, or at least try to do, every day. When we look at the importance of sleep through the lens of how it affects mental processes, studies show that sleep is fundamental for memory consolidation, concentration, creativity, and our emotional state. Let's explore these four crucial elements related to sleep in more detail. Mapping out the exact processes of sleep stages and active memory consolidation is difficult and complex. However, many studies support that adequate sleep and quantity of sleep better helps transfer short-term memories to long-term. It is hypothesized that during sleep, neural connections of recently learned information are strengthened, making sleep a conducive environment for memory consolidation. Shifting our focus to its impact on concentration, sleep is also very important in enhancing your attention span, which better facilitates learning. Studies reveal that individuals lacking sleep absorb new information at a slower rate and experience delayed reaction times. It's similar to the need of repeatedly rereading a sentence because your mind momentarily goes blank. Moving on, a lack of sleep also has a negative impact on creativity and problem solving. During some stages of sleep, the brain engages in a creative process that links ideas together. Therefore, a sleep-deprived person may have these processes restricted. Lastly, sleep is also a good indicator of someone's mood and overall well-being. Compared to sleep-deprived individuals, well-rested individuals are more likely to show positive behavioral traits. In the context of learning, students are better able to process information when they have a balanced emotional state. So how is sleep engaged in these processes? Let's dive right in and explore the mechanisms underlying sleep. When you go to sleep, your body doesn't just shut down. It goes through different stages of sleep. There are two main phases. The first phase is called non-rapid eye movement, also known as NREM. The other phase is called rapid eye movement, also known as REM. These phases include variations in muscle tone, brainwave patterns, and eye movements. Let's take a closer look at these two phases. The initial phase, NREM, can be broken down into three stages, N1, N2, and N3. N1 is the first stage. It is a short, light sleep phase that usually lasts a few minutes. Muscular activity decreases, and it's relatively easy to wake up during this stage. As we progress deeper into sleep, we reach the second stage, N2. This is a slightly deeper stage than N1. During N2, the heart rate slows and the body temperature decreases, essentially preparing the body for a deeper sleep. The last stage is N3, often referred to as deep sleep. It is challenging to be awake from this stage. N3 plays a crucial role in physical healing, immune function, and leaves you feeling refreshed when you wake up. Now that we covered the basics of NREM, let's take a look at the second phase, REM. REM sleep is when our brain activity increases and our eyes move rapidly. We experience vivid dreams and our voluntary muscles become temporarily paralyzed, preventing us from physically acting out our dreams. REM sleep is also essential for cognitive functioning and emotional regulation, contributing to one's well-being during sleep. During a typical night's sleep, most people go through the NREM and REM phases about 4-6 times, with each phase lasting roughly 90 minutes. Now you may be wondering, how many hours of sleep should you get? According to the National Sleep Foundation, individuals between the ages of 18 to 25 should aim for 7 to 9 hours of sleep daily for optimal health. But this is not a one-size-fits-all standard. The amount of sleep you need may vary depending on your environment, medical circumstances, and your genetic factors. However, this guideline is accurate for most people. So what happens when you fail to get an adequate amount of sleep? Well, according to the Sleep Foundation, sleep deficiency can cause daytime struggles such as difficulty concentrating, remembering things, and even slower reaction times. Additionally, it can alter your mood, triggering anxiety, irritability, and depression, while also contributing to the weight gain, health issues, and a noticeable decrease in energy. To illustrate how serious sleep deprivation can be, the Canadian Council of Motor Transport Administrators stated that drowsiness contributes to 21% of car accidents in Canada. Those who sleep less than 5 hours per night are over 5 times more likely to experience a car crash compared to those who get 7 or more hours of sleep. While operating a vehicle without adequate sleep is comparable to the dangers of driving under the influence, staying awake for 24 hours can be equivalent to 0.1 blood alcohol content, which surpasses the legal limit of 0.08%. The problem of insufficient sleep among students persists and continues to go unnoticed due to the misguided perception that sacrificing sleep for academic success is a commendable display of dedication. Moreover, there are many preconceived notions and misconceptions that influence students into unhealthy sleepy patterns.
Sleep deficiency and deprivation are common among the student population. Research shows that approximately 96% of college students get less than 8 hours of sleep on weeknights, with over half of them getting less than 7 hours of sleep per night. Based on a study done by Gilbert and Weaver in 2010, they found that poor sleep quality was associated with lower academic performance. They stated that students that lack sleep had a harder time recalling information, thinking critically, and concentrating on their test. These results were consistent with another study in 2022. Students who were sleep-deprived showed poor performance on cognitive tasks despite having the expectation that they would perform at the same level as students who had enough sleep. Sleep deprivation also has negative effects on the reconstructing of the brain. When researchers looked at the activity of brain regions of sleep-deprived people, they found that some areas of the brain important for cognition were noticeably impaired compared to non-sleep-deprived students.
Most will agree that getting sufficient sleep is important, but in the student life, we see it starting to become more of a luxury. However, there are some strategies that students can use to find a balance between their studies and their sleep. For example, avoiding procrastination, aiming to complete assignments well ahead of deadlines, attending your classes regularly to avoid last-minute cramming, and planning your study sessions during the day or early evenings are different ways you can balance sleep and schoolwork. Despite our focus on only the neurological impact of sleep deprivation, there are countless other drawbacks associated with poor sleep. So the next time you're planning your study schedule, maybe think twice before sacrificing your sleep.